Should you happen to be over in the UK, UK FrightFest is returning to London and the Cineworld, Leicester Square, and the Prince Charles Cinema, August 25th through 29th. Now, if you're a fan of Neil Marshall, who has, of course, put out the film, one of my favorite werewolf films, Dog Soldiers, he's got a new film coming out called The Lair, which is described as an action-packed gore shocker. The Dirty Half Dozen Meets The Thing is how he describes it. So definitely something to look forward to should you be in the UK during that time period. Scott Mann's Fall is actually going to be the closing film, and that particular one involves two friends stranded at the top of a remote 2,000-foot tower, and it's a survival horror film. So presses are on sale should you be in the UK July 16th. So, you know, like right today, and single ticket sales start on the 23rd at noon. So should, like I said, should you be there, then I would personally love to go. And if you're looking forward to the new adaptation of Salem's Lot, you're going to have to wait a little bit longer. It was going to come out September of this year. It has now been pushed back to April of 2023. No particular word on why, but there's a lot of reasons why things move from one date to another. Sometimes it's finishing the effects. Sometimes it's schedule changes that require shuffling the whole board for whatever the studio is putting out. And this is coming from New Line. This also involves pushing the new remake of Train to Busan from Timo Tajajanto, I'm sure it is mangled his name. That actually is going to get moved off that date because that was coming out in April of 2023 was its release window, and that is now going to have to change. We'll have more news, of course, once we get some more fixed dates. And news continues to come out about the new Scream 6, whatever the title turns out to be. Samara Weaving from Ready or Not has joined the cast. Tony Revolori from Spider-Man Homecoming has also joined the cast. Apparently, Weaving was considered for the previous film, but for whatever reasons, didn't work out, primarily scheduling. Now, of course, this has turned out to have a pretty solid returning cast. Of course, not a certain person, but Hayden Panettiere, pardon me, has from Scream 4 is coming back, and of course Courtney Cox is as well. If you are a fan of David Morrell, goodness, that name might ring a bell from, he's the guy who actually wrote the Rambo novel, which of course sparked the entire franchise that has been going on for decades, and certainly not the only stuff that he wrote. Creepers is one of his horror novels. It came out in 2005, and it is the story of a bunch of urban explorers who plan to check out an old boarded up hotel. Lots of opportunities to explore, and you can find, of course, all these amazing urban explorer photographs all over the web. So I mean, this is definitely something that has got a very modern feel, even though it's a, you know, almost 20-year-old book. But of course, they run into complications, not only human in the form of some other urban explorers who are not as nice, but something else is in the building who isn't choosing sides. It's just on its own. So something to look forward to there. We don't actually have a date on this, but it's Suretone Pictures and Lionsgate are doing the co-financing on the adaptation of this film. And the long journey, personified here by the Dread Central Development Hell podcast picture for it, which is actually a place you can find a ton of information about the Five Nights at Freddy's saga attempting to bring it to the screen. Well, Jason Blum has said it is still happening. It is still working its way through with the intent of this actually happening. So I don't know if I believe it. We'll see when we get it. But if you're interested in diving into the ins and outs of it, this particular podcast is definitely something you want to check out if you're a fan, because it has been a very long and very, very winding road. And we knew we'd get more. We finally have the poster. Finally? Am I air quoting here? Yeah, let's air quote that. Winnie the Pooh, Blood and Honey. With the move of Winnie the Pooh into the public domain, you knew this was happening. We've talked about it before. There's the poster. This ain't no bedtime story is the tagline here. That's all I'm going to say. And the first poster for Orphan First Kill, the sequel to the 2009 film Orphan, has been revealed. This, of course, tells the story of a apparently young woman who turns out to be not as young as she appears to be. She gets adopted, seemingly appearing to be a child. Of course, is a grown woman who is a bit murdery. And Julia Stiles is going to star in this film, or stars in this film as well. It's already in production. I don't think we actually have a release date on this yet, but it is on its way. If you're a fan of the first film, the second film looks like it's shaping up to be more of the same kind of stabby fun. And this one seems really interesting because, of course, we're fans of foreign horror here. SALOUM is coming to Shudder on February, September 2nd. It's going to come to streaming September 8th. And then a national rollout on September 9th. Jean-Luc Hébreau, who directed a film called Dealer, is the director on this. It was a big release at Midnight Madness in 2021 Toronto International Film Festival. Lots of great buzz. Went on to Fantastic Fest 2021, Red Sea International Festival, whole bunch of other ones. Lots of praise. Now, this is basically involves a plane that is shot down with a bunch of mercenaries inside. They have to stash the stolen gold. They're on the run from a drug lord. There's all kinds of just, the standard kind of mercenary story on the run. They take refuge at a holiday camp. And this is all set in Africa. So it's the very much leaning into a lot of African folklore and horror to work on this. And of course, the folks at this resort have all kinds of things going on, but there's also something else going on. It's described as a bold combination of horror, revenge, thriller, and African folklore that's worth every bit of praise it's been receiving at festivals, according to Shudder General Manager Craig Engler. Honestly, this is going to be something that I'm looking forward to. We don't get a lot of African horror coming over to the U.S., and I would definitely take more of it. And Black Phone has been blowing up a lot in terms of really fantastic positive reviews, and it is now actually coming to on-demand outlets. It's still in theaters. Friday, yesterday, it has actually arrived, I guess there is more accurate. It's still playing in theaters. You can still check it up on the big screen, but if you are not able to do that or don't feel comfortable doing that, or just not playing at a theater near you, you can definitely check it out as well. It's available on demand. It has currently crossed the $100 million worldwide mark, which is always great to see for a horror film. And if you haven't heard about the dead girl in Apartment 3, well, I hadn't heard about it either. But one of the things that we now have learned is Adrienne King, who survived the original Friday the 13th, Mrs. Voorhees' last intended victim, didn't quite work out for her. Now, talk about Friday the 13th Part 2. But she is actually returning to horror in The Dead Girl in Apartment 3. It's coming out in this September. The premise is a young woman moves to an apartment in New York City. She discovers that her roommate had died in her apartment. And then after the body is taken away, she discovers there's an unseen presence. It's all going to go wrong for her there. But we'll have to see what happens when that comes out on September 3rd. And Omar Epps, Demi Singleton, Anthony B. Jenkins, and Miss Lawrence have joined the cast of the new exorcism thriller, The Deliverance. It's coming from Lee Daniels. This is going to be on Netflix. This is, of course, based on a true story of a mother whose family and world is turned upside down by possession event. This was originally a very, you know, we didn't have a title, we didn't have details, but now we have this much. Daniels is also, Lee Daniels is not only the director, but he's also one of the co-writers on the film. And I'm sure we'll have a lot more here when we actually get a trailer for it. But it's definitely an interesting looking project. She Came from the Woods is a summer camp horror comedy, campy 80s feel kind of film. A bunch of counselors who, of course, accidentally, as they do, unleash ancient evil on the last night of their summer camp. And they have to determine what stories are worth telling and what secrets are worth keeping. It's described as a refreshing, riotously fun take on a classic horror subgenre. Its world premiere is going to be at the FrightFest in London in August. And so we'll have to see. But Bluefront Films has got the worldwide rights for this. So we'll have to see. Now it's going to star Stranger Things' Cara Bono, Claire Foley from Sinister, Spencer List from Good Trouble, and William Sadler from The Shawshank Redemption, and a few other films William Sadler has been in. Should be fun. And we put this poster up last week when the original reveal, but the trailer has actually dropped for the Rob Zombie, The Munsters. And it looks like we're getting, I guess, kind of an origin story. No kids in this yet. It looks like the first meeting of Herman and Lily and the flowering of their relationship, true love conquering all, as we led off with here. Because Grandpa Munster doesn't seem too fond of the idea. Some initial negative response for the texture of the trailer, the visual texture in terms of how it looks. It looks, some folks have reacted to looking at very much like sort of a kitschy 1960s TV series, which of course it is, but it's based on, but at the same time, there's something that looks kind of flat about it. So your mileage may vary on this, but if you haven't seen it, check it out. It looks a lot like a Munsters movie. We'll have to see. On the video and DVD side, Yellow Brick Road is coming to Blu-ray for the very first time. If you're not familiar with Yellow Brick Road, well, there was a town that one day got up in the 1940s and wandered off down a path. And their bodies, what bodies were found, indicated some sort of mass suicide murder. It's a mystery. It's been covered up. In the modern day, a group of researchers dive into the mystery to not terribly surprising results. It was originally released by Bloody Disgusting Selects title. They finally digitally restored the film. It is the 10th anniversary of the picture. And August 9th is the release date on this. Apparently, there's going to be a lot of extras and special features on this, but including, practical blood effects on an indie budget, walking the yellow brick road, cast and crew interviews, commentaries, et cetera, et cetera. So we'll see that. I thought it was an interesting film. Mixed feelings, to be honest, but it was an interesting film. And Night of the Living Dead, we might be getting, this is a rumor, 4K Ultra HD release supposedly on its way. This is just a rumor. Digital Bits apparently has somebody who has been reliable in the past and informed them that Criterion is working on this. We'll see. I mean, of course, it's a popular film that would benefit from such a thing, and a lot of folks would be really happy to have this happen. But we'll wait and see. Be great. I'd love a copy. And Alex Garland's Men, the film he made with A24, came out in May in theaters. is coming to DVD, Blu-ray, and digital August 9th from Lionsgate. Not a lot of lists on the extras here. Apparently just a making of at this time. But if you enjoyed that film, you'll want to pick that up. And in news that is pretty cool, Squid Game, of course, the juggernaut of a series that is getting sequels, is getting a live-action version, real game thing. It's made history again. It has actually become the first non-English language show to secure an Emmy nomination in the main drama category. There have been other things that have been gotten nominations from overseas, but it is the first to get the main drama category nomination. Now, it doesn't mean a win, but it's also got nomination in Outstanding Drama Series category, and also for star Lee Jung-jae. It scored 14 Emmy nominations overall, which is nothing to sneer at. Speaking of Emmy nominations, What We Do in the Shadows also has gotten some Emmy nominations here. Outstanding Comedy Series. Now, it has yet to win an Emmy, even though it's been nominated before. And shockingly, I know you're shocked, Stranger Things has also got 13 Primetime Emmy nominations. Outstanding Drama Series is one of them, but it did not get any acting nominations for any of its stars. A lot of people are kind of surprised about this. You have the inevitable lists of the snubs of the Emmys, and this is going to show up on here. A lot of them were submitted for Emmy nomination consideration, but they did not get it. And if you're wanting more Stranger Things, there's a couple of things coming up. First of all, Finn Wolfhard we talked about this 3 or 4 months ago, where he was actually gearing up to direct a film of his own, a horror comedy slasher movie. And this is actually going ahead. It's called Hell of a Summer. And he's writing and directing Billy Brick from Ghostbusters Afterlife is his writing and directing co-partner on this. And of course, we'll have a lot more information about that as it develops. But talented young person out there doing a lot of cool things. And if you caught season 4, you know that Eddie Munson was the true hero of the season. Spoiler alerts. Well, he's being memorialized by Crop Art. And this is actually hits a little close to home because the artist is from the Kansas City area. Stan Hurd of Lawrence, Kansas, does a lot of this crop art all over the world. He's actually he's done political figures, he's done astronauts, he's done all kinds of things. This is the Eddie Munson crop art that he's done, which has been posted all over. It's been part of a tribute video for the Stranger Things characters. This is sitting in Indiana, should you feel so inclined to make, I don't know, a pilgrimage. I'm sure there's an entry fee or something. We got our first teaser for Tales from the Walking Dead. It's very short, about 30 seconds long. A lot of shots of the actors, a little bit of a tagline, do you want to try something new? Coming from Parker Posey. But Olivia Munn, Daniel Pindella, Terry Crews, Parker Posey, Jillian Bell, Poppy Liu, and Anthony Edwards. 6 different stories, one dead world. And it looks like, of course, pretty much what we were expecting, the sort of anthology series show. So definitely, however you feel about the Walking Dead universe will probably indicate whether or not you enjoy the trailer, you know? And Killer Camp is coming from Amazon Prime Video. This is a Dutch adaptation of Tuesday's Child Television's slasher horror whodunit reality TV competition. This is a 6-part series. 11 well-known influencers from the Netherlands are going to check into an 80s-style American summer camp called Camp Pleasant. One of them will be hatching a murderous plan, forcing them all to fight for their lives. no one's lives are supposed to be actually in danger here, but they're going to attempt to win a $20,000 cash prize. By day, they do funny camp challenges, and then by night, one is going to be picked off and air quote murdered. So yeah, this should be something very interesting. Supposedly later this year, we don't have a release date for that. I'm not a big reality TV show, game show person, but if they're going to keep crossing this stuff over with horror, I'm going to have to check some of this stuff out. And the success of Chucky season one, of course, led to Chucky season two. And we now have actual release date, October 5th, 2022. It's about at 9 p.m. on USA and the Sci-Fi Channel. The teaser trailer is out. And so you've got that to look forward to. We also have the Reginald the Vampire, which is Jacob Batalon's series, October 5th, coming out at 10 p.m. on Sci-Fi. And that's, of course, inspired by a book series by Johnny B. Truant. And the track record on Alien games has not always been great, but we are getting a new one. Video game VR game developer Survios and 20th Century Games are coming together on this. Don't have a whole lot of information on what we have so far, but on July 21st, at the Alien Expanding a Dark and Frightening Universe panel at San Diego Comic-Con, there is supposed to be more information revealed about this, so we will definitely have more news about this. And these folks have done stuff with Walking Dead Onslaught, Westworld Awakening, and got their own stuff they're developing as well. And if you find yourself at San Diego Comic-Con and you are a fan of In the Mouth of Madness or John Carpenter, well, you actually get to see Mrs. Pickman in all her tentacle glory. She's going to be making her first appearance at San Diego Comic-Con. And it's going to be at the Storm King's Comics exhibition, which, of course, Storm King Comics is the comics company that Sandy King who runs. They're both going to be on hand to do panels and signings and the like. And, whoops, there we go. Finally, should you find yourself in the UK, UK has all sorts of fun things, and wish to, I don't know, torture yourself. Lionsgate and Twisted Pictures have teamed up with the Path Entertainment Group. Saw the Experience is going to be a brand new multi-room escape experience at a secret location in London sometime this fall. Now, if you're familiar with the Saw series, this sounds like a wonderful way to get new victims for the villains of Saw. So I'm not sure how much you feel about reality crossing over with fantasy and vice versa. But it's a thing you can do. You can register now for it at thesawexperience.com. I'm sorry, www.sawexperience.com. But, you know, of course, these escape rooms are very popular. And Saw, it seems like a great fit. Just, I don't know if I necessarily trust that the folks who are working on it have my best interests at heart. I'm sure they do. Got to make a profit. And that's all I've got for you guys this morning. I hope you have a fantastic weekend. And I hope that you will join us later as we dive into just a little bit of horror from the across the seas with our own foreign bodies. Coming up later today. Thanks for watching, folks, and we will see you next week.
Good morning, Multiverse. Saturday morning at 11, 10 Central, only on Sci-Fi for Me TV.